Hey, Llama here. Just wanted to talk a little bit about the upcoming fishing video you guys are going to see. I let you guys down, got skunked, had fun, part of the Llama pack, crushed it, but I forgot to charge my camera. I had 2 hours left, completed, used it, forgot to go through it, turn it off on the last stretch of the river. So when we hit the lake, you guys missed all the action. What I've done is I managed to get a quick snap on my cell phone. Hopefully I can bring that in, get it edited for you guys, and tweaked in there. But the biggest thing is some learning stuff for me is I figured out how to place this on my chest. So this is the first time using my GoPro with the chest mount. Didn't get it configured correctly. Partly to blame because I wanted to get out on that river so quick. So got it set, thought I had it set right. A few of my shots are good, a few of them are bad. Gonna make this a compilation for you. Go ahead, mash the like, mash the subscribe. This is only gonna get better as we start moving through. Hey guys, we're here. Beautiful Price River, Lower Fish Creek, as you can see. Beautiful. We're gonna be walking down that. We're going with the pink trout magnet and a float. As you can see, the water's not super fast, but we're gonna try and see if we can get something out of here. Again, I've never used a trout magnet here in Utah. See, the guys in Washington use it, as well as Virginia, and have it be a little successful. It's been pretty cool. So we'll see. Got my hopes up there a little bit. Don't think it was fish hunter. Just down from the dam, so this section for the about a mile, we could actually use live bait if we wanted to, worms, power bait, any of that aspect. But I figure why not try the trout magnet right out of the gates. The river, I don't know if you can see it, it's a little mossy, a lot of algae at the bottom, grass. I've got the trout magnet just set to float right above it. But I'm trying to debate if gold's the right color. I might go silver. So I've made a little change. Went with the silver trout magnet and a weighted float. I want to get over into the other side a little bit further and see what I can get over there. See if I can rip something from shore. Keli's doing the same thing. He's going with the weighted float. I changed it up and went with that little orange trout magnet. I'm hitting bottom. I can tell that right now. But Keli's using a green, the neon green, and I think he's got a gold tip. this guy on video. So we're, there he is. It's the guy I see over there swimming across the water. It's like a little ferret. It's not even a beaver. I want to call it an otter, but he's too small to be an otter. So see him running up on the side over there. He spooked Keli. Keli thought it was a fish. So, but he is seeing some over there in front of him. Alright guys, switch spot. We're trying. I just missed one. He bobbered down and everything, and I failed miserably. I got too excited. So, I am 0 for 4 today. Okay guys, I lost my trout magnet and my weighted bobber. I just had it in and I wasn't ready for it. Did you guys see that? He came right out of the right out from underneath those weeds and hit me. Let's see if he'll do it again. Keli had some action as soon as we got to this spot. Let's see if we can get it. Kelly's going weighted bobber and power worm. I'm trout float and trout magnet. And that one guy looks like he might be the only one. But I can't get out to where Kelly's getting out to. With his bobber. I'm gonna slide around Keli here. Something here. Big boy just surfaced right there. Right in that area. Skittish. These things are hit once and then they're not coming back for it again. So I don't know if they're liking the taste. They don't like the taste or they feel the steel. I decided. Got him. Yeah, I got him. Fish on. There we go. Oh, I gotta get my there. Oh, I lost him. I lost him. He went down into the weeds and I lost him because my drag was too loose. Oh man, that hurt. That was insulting. Man, so I'm going to put it to rest now, officially. Trout magnets work. I had fish on. Again, I'm a poor fisher. So I'm 0 for 5 now. But we saw a fight finally. So, let's see if there's another one over here. Yeah, that guy hit me hard. And I did switch to a green and black trout magnet. The water's a little bit more clear here. I figured I'd get rid of the golds and the silvers. I just missed one. Got him. Kelly's got one right over here. Nice. we're gonna go take a peek here with Keli. You got your net behind you. It's a nice little cut. It's a nice cut. Putting up a bite. There we go, guys. First fish of the day by Keli. Nice fat cutthroat. Big believer in the farmer's almanac, and then I use in fishermen's solar tables, and I'm a big proponent of all that stuff, right? Because it wouldn't be there. People didn't believe in it and use it, and it tended to strike out pretty well for me, especially lake fishing. So what we're gonna do is we're probably gonna wrap it up here on the river. We're gonna pop up to Schofield and we're gonna get some shots in. Now here's my major concern. Where I parked the SUV, I left all of our lake poles in there. So the big concern is when we get back there, do we trust people? Have they broken the SUV? If not, we're good and we got the poles. So far, if you guys have liked all my content, everything that I'm doing, talking about, click on like, go ahead and hit subscribe, click on the llama head in the lower right hand corner, and I'm gonna get more content going to you, a lot more every week. This upcoming Friday I'm going out July 3rd, looking to do some 4th of July fishing, get away from everything. Got a rough end of quarter at work, so you know, it's the big escape. I don't know how I'm gonna get this one included, but I had to record it because Keli, right there, today. We're doing good. We've limited out. One of us is limited out in about 25 minutes. The other one, me, has managed to catch 3 cuts, all within the slot. Have to let them go. So, there we are.